Dana says, hello, wish you guys were closer.
Well, how much closer do you want to be? I mean, I can get... Is that close enough? What the fuck?
Melissa, that's a clip.
How much closer do you want me to get? Damn.
Lou said, yes, I'm in New Zealand.
Hope I didn't see, see any boogers.
Probably.
You think so?
Oh my God.
Is my nose up or down?
Jade, thanks, guys.
Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory and grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Yeah! Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of the Solid Canine Training Center. This is the What Would Jeff Do show. Do you have something in your eye?
Yes.
It's oh, really, are you blinking?
It's bothering me really bad.
I know. Don't you hate that?
I feel like I have a scratch in my eyeball.
I know. Sorry about that. This is the lovely Joelle with scratchy eyes.
Oh my gosh, it's so bad.
They call her Scratchy Eyes Gifford. And I hope everyone's doing okay tonight. So this is a Q&A show. You ask a question, Joelle types it, and then I read it.
I don't type it, I read it.
You type it, you read it.
You answer okay. it.
I'm trying to think of the chart there, the flow chart. And then I'll give you an answer. A lot of the answers need a lot of time, but I give you a 15-second answer. A lot of times they're a little bit quirky. A lot of times you don't like the answer and write me hate mail. And then, but notice the line of questioning. It's always on, how do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? It's really important to understand that because people are looking for answers on how to stop unwanted behaviors.
Mm-hmm.
And our seminar series that we travel the world in this year,
screeching
off. Like, we've had to replace the brakes 5 times this year. That also is a problem. So like, seminars, think about seminars for everything out there. Mm-hmm. And there's dog training seminars for lots of stuff. Like literally, there's agility training seminars, bike work training seminars, how to increase the drive in your dog. They have puppy raising seminars. Our seminar series is problem solving seminars. Again, how to stop bad behavior in dogs.
Mm.
So we show people actually how to apply a proper punisher. So between the seminars and the show, you hear a lot about punishment. Call it a correction. Call it an intolerable consequence. Call it whatever you want, but it is not a reward. Now, are rewards used in stopping unwanted behavior? No. They're used as step two. Mm-hmm. Step two, stop the unwanted behavior. Then you can start rewarding for the stuff you want. But if you reward for the stuff you want and you ignore the bad behavior, it will not go away no matter how powerful you make the stuff you want. It just doesn't work that way. My dog has the best sit in the world. Uh-huh. But it still jumps on people. Teach it even a better sit. No, it doesn't work that way. Meanwhile, at the training center, we do it all. So at the training center, dogs live here 24/7 for 6 weeks, for sometimes 8 weeks, sometimes 4 weeks. And they go through a combination of obedience work and rehab. So ironically, we do tons of reward-based training. We food train dogs. We go through tons of food. We marker train, which is either yes or no. And instead of yes, we can also use a clicker. And we clicker train dogs. So there is something called Top Chat or Super Chat, and that is available on YouTube only. Thank you for all the people that are watching on YouTube. Thank you for all the people that are watching this live on Facebook, for all the people watching the replay. Thank you very much. And for all the people listening on the 20 different podcast platforms that we're on, thank you as well. And you can do a Top Chat. And what you do with a Top Chat is you just type it in and you pick a dollar amount. And your number, your question does go to the top of the queue. We do answer it right away, but you do not have to pay to play. But there is there's a couple hundred questions. I try to answer as many as possible. Joelle's pontificating all night long, so sometimes it's hard to get an answer in. And so we're going to do our best. And here we go.
All right. Greg says hello.
Hello.
Brandy, holy crap, I finally get to see
you. Oh, holy shit, Brandy, we finally get to see you on a live. Welcome.
Yeah. I just got bumped and the show just started.
Oh,
Tracy says hello.
Hey, Tracy.
Amy, thank you for all the helpful information.
Well, thank you for incorporating the helpful information.
Melissa says, good evening all. Happy Wednesday.
Hey, Melissa, thanks for being here.
Irene, good evening, everyone.
Hello, Irene.
Kathy, I want to say since Sharon's spring seminar, I've been working with Kate and Run by Dogs, and she's doing so much better. Thank you, Jeff and Joelle.
Oh, that's so bad. I was just thinking about that the other day because
that's a good
seminar about mushing.
That was so fun.
That was mushing.
Her property is so nice.
Yeah. Oh my, was it 100 acres or something? Oh my God. That was rolling hills. Yeah. Cell service sucked though, huh?
Sure did.
Jeez, next.
Oh, Greg, I had to use corrective stimulus to stop my Aussie from biting the running weed whacker. Will using that hurt my constant pressure training?
No, but stop using such weird words, okay? Okay, you shocked your dog, okay? You shocked your dog. So keep in mind
that it is corrective stimulus.
I know, but still, I like to call it just you shocked your dog, you corrected your dog, okay? This is the thing. We have dogs that come in here on night one, they bark. They get corrected with corrected stimulus, of course. They get corrected. The next day, they do leash pressure work, some food training, some marker work, some spatial pressure exercises. Night two, barking still a little bit, they get corrected.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they jump up on us. They get corrected. Maybe they try to bite us. They get corrected. Day three, day four, we start working on low-level remote collar work, and they just do fine. Next.
Mary, off topic, but I love your glasses, Joelle.
Mary, it's right on topic because it's about Joelle. Next.
Stop it. Greg said that I haven't started yet. Oh, like continuous stim, like escape conditioning. He went right to a correction.
Got it. You can go, for correction for bad behaviors, but we do escape conditioning. We have a whole program where we prime the dog, we see it, we do CS, we do NCS, then we go to correction on all the remote collar stuff. So for all the folks out there, so actually I thought about a new thing.
One thing you haven't done yet?
Yeah, but we have a new series coming out.
I finished editing that one.
So did you come up with a title for it?
No.
Yeah.
In the arena?
In the arena. Yeah, we have a new series coming out. So we do our Q&A, and then we do something called What Would Jeff Do Goes Deep, where I actually take questions and concepts, and I go a little bit deeper into them. And then we do a seminar sit-down, which I go over concepts we do at our seminar. So, but we have a new one that we're coming out with, which I really think I'm going to enjoy. Next.
Blessing, how to fix over-socialization to people. Goose has impulse control and can now walk by people without looking and knows no and can recall off of people. However, she isn't neutral. How do I get her to be neutral?
Sounds like she's neutral. She walks by people without looking. That's neutral.
Right.
And she can recall off people, which is fine. But I mean, you can have a dog that's neutral, like, to people.
But still super friendly when the time and place. But
friendly.
Yeah. That sounds fine to me.
That sounds fine to me. I mean, if you want your dog to ignore all people and have no interaction with people, which is fine if that's what you want, every time your dog went up to somebody, you'd correct it.
I've seen if there's like any more to that. Oh, there is more. Okay. Brandy says, miss you.
Miss you too, Brandy.
Vincenza, I was trying to correct my Cane Corso because he had my son's toy in his mouth. I had the e-collar on at 30. He refused to give up the toy. I'm afraid to go super high on the e-collar. Mm-hmm. What's a safe high number without me being afraid that I'm really hurting him?
Okay, so Vincenzo, let's talk about this because a lot of people struggle with this. Why are you so afraid do you realize that your dog could die? So your dog could ingest the toy and die. Or your son could try to grab the toy out of its mouth, or you could grab the toy out of its mouth and your dog could guard it and bite you. That's one thing. Number two, what's the problem when your dog picks up something it's not allowed to, applying something that is either slightly or very uncomfortable to the dog? And then what's your definition of hurt? Most people think it's long-term, which is called imagined harm. So your remote goes up to 100. If the dog was trying to bite your son, would you be so concerned about hurting the dog or not? Oh, of course not. So you're actually not concerned about hurting the dog, are you? Correct? That's a good question to ponder for everybody. All the folks out there that say they would never hit or kick their dog or inflict pain, really? So if your dog was biting your child, you wouldn't hit it or kick it or inflict pain? Really? Remind me not to be your kid around one of your dogs. So what you're going to do is you're going to say no and correct. If 30 doesn't work, you go to 50. If 50 doesn't work, you go to 70. If 70 doesn't work, you go to 100. The dog controls the remote. That's actually going to be one of my sit downs.
Did you write it down? Because you know we're both going to forget that.
I think I did at one point. The dog controls the remote. Always remember that the dog controls the remote. Now, I have three high drive working dogs. Rarely wear a collar, any collar, rarely on leash. 99% of the time they're off leash dogs, naked, no equipment. But when we go into the woods, I put remote collars on them. Why? Because Mother Nature doesn't care a lot about my training.
Nope.
And any dog trainer out there should admit that their dog fucks up in certain situations. So my dogs, my high drive dogs, they work on single digits, meaning 9 and below. If they're chasing deer, they blow through 100 and they don't make a peep and they don't miss a step. Think about that. The dog controls the remote. Next.
Lou, hi J&J. Snow here today. Maisie went nuts outside. Her first snow. Great to watch.
Where the fuck's it?
He's in New Zealand, I think.
Oh.
It's okay. Winter there, right?
Either that or he fucking lives on a cocaine farm. Next.
I'm pretty sure he's in New Zealand. Okay. Greg said, I shocked my dog.
Good.
Annie, hi guys. Hope all is well.
Hey, Annie, things are fantastic.
Greg says,
not a Greg shock. His dog things are good.
Greg says, thanks. Daniel, I like your guys' show. Good stuff.
Thank you so much, Daniel. We try to educate.
Jade, hey guys, how are you going? Question. I recently got asked from a client to have their money back from our dog program. The owner put little to no work in, and when I refused to give it back, she put a small claim in through court. How would you guys deal with this?
Well, Jade, sounds like your pre-screening process failed. Failed dramatically. So how well do you pre-screen? How well? That's never happened to me in 15 years. None of those things. How well do you pre-screen clients? So that could have been probably weeded out at the beginning. You let them in the door. So how would I deal with it? I would deal with it the way the chips fell, because it's called 100% responsibility. You let them in the door, you've got to be responsible for it. So that's your decision. How would you deal with it? What do you feel now at this point in the situation, even knowing you probably did your job and you probably have video proof of it? Number one, how many hours did you spend with the owner, working with the owner? Did the owner know what they had to do prior to this? Does the owner also, so that's one thing. Number two, if you want to fight it, does the owner have a habit of putting in small claims for everything?
Sounds like it.
Okay. Also, but I would own it. I would own it. To me, I would say I let the wrong person in. Now, make a decision. Make a decision. Whatever you feel the most comfortable with. Next.
Melissa posted a link to our website to book a virtual one-on-one.
I'm doing console. A lot of one-on-ones. I'm almost, some days I'm maxed out. Today was out of control. Today was out of control. So for all the folks that are doing one-on-ones around the world too, got one coming up in Russia.
Wow.
Yeah, I did one in Japan this week.
That's cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really, really cool. Time zones throw you off a little bit, but it works. The ones that are like 12-hour time zones, 13-hour time zones, those are fine. They're just on different days.
Right.
So, you know, my Monday, your Tuesday.
Right.
Next.
Eliana, I correct my dog for staring, which leads up to her being reactive, but she will still side-eye or whine after her correction. Do I correct multiple times or do I find the level?
I got a feeling you're underwhelming your dog. You're underwhelming your dog. Next.
Iona says hi.
Hey, Iona, how are you?
Andrea, we chatted over a video consult a couple weeks ago, and your advice on the pit that was trying to escape from the crate worked. Couple corrections and done. He's home now, and his family is so
awesome.
Happy.
I'm glad that it worked. So what you're probably referring to is, I refer to this all the time, and this is what you are told not to do. You are told not to do this. Correct. I'm going to tear up about this because I get so emotional. I get all verklempt. Can we talk? So it's way before your time. Who said that, folks?
What are you even saying right now?
Who said that? Who said that? Okay.
That was like the weirdest accent.
I know, like, but I'll look up that video tonight.
It's like New Jersey or something.
No, I'll look up the video tonight, and you'll be like, "Holy shit, that's what Jeff did." So, five points extra for whoever can list who said that. All right. Never have anything negative happen to your dog in a crate. Never correct it.
Never
do anything because the dog will have a bad crate association. Okay. Let's think rationally. Which I know it's a rough one these days. Mm. I know it's hard to connect. It's hard to connect the dots for a lot of people these days. The dog is breaking out of the crates. So the negative thing is already happening.
Already there.
Hey, dog trainer, can you help me? Yeah, make the crate more fun. So now my dog is trying to break out of a fun crate. Mm. Okay. So, or make trying to break out of a crate suck. Holy shit, it worked, Jeff. I know it did. Next.
Sean, hello guys. I have a 2-year-old Malinois. When I have him on a leash and sit him, he takes a step or two to the side in front of me. Should I allow that or have him sit directly next to me immediately?
All depends on what your rules are. I would work on that a little bit farther back. Next.
Ronnie, can you recommend any good books dog related?
But believe it or not, I think a really good book is called Closing the Gap by the Good Dog. And it's not because he's a friend of mine.
By Sean O'Shea.
Dog. Good dog, you know, but it's a really good book. It's actually a really good book helping you understand like just what goes on with your dog and you as a human. Next.
Ronnie, can you recommend? I already read that. Joelle, thanks so much for the tip on using the prong instead of a flat collar when teaching Nick to sit on chairs. She finally did it and now does it without leash pressure.
Awesome. Yeah, yeah. Can people have to remember that like flat collars choke dogs, martingales choke dogs, slippery choke dogs. It's like I'm fully aware of the prong collar and how barbaric it looks. I'm fully aware of that, but it's designed actually not to harm your dog. Next.
Good dog coaching and pet care. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. I'll be there tomorrow for your shadow program.
Awesome.
Not even COVID could keep me away from this great opportunity for girls. So excited.
Awesome. So just to let you know, 9:30 would be a good time to start tomorrow.
Yeah.
Because somebody comes in at 9, but actually, you can come in here at 9 and start working in the kennels. You can come here as early as 8, but that's up to you. Next.
Vincenza, got it. Thank you for that perspective.
You're welcome.
Robbie, hi, J&J. My dog whines and gets overexcited when I get the leash out to go for a walk. Mm-hmm. I've started to put him in a sit or down, and I do something else until he settles. Mm-hmm. But as soon as I approach to put his collar on, he starts all over again. No. Should I extend the time in a down, or is there another method you can advise? Thank you in advance.
If you extend the time in a down...
You're gonna have time.
It's
for your
like
walk.
Dinner time. Okay. It's like we started our
breakfast. Missed your walk opportunity.
It's like we do a walk every day before breakfast. It's like we don't finish until after dinner. I'm like, what? How far do you walk? Oh, we get down the driveway. Why? I'm waiting him to settle down. So, or what you can do is this. Bonker. This sounds so counterintuitive.
Counterproductive.
Counterproductive too. That one I knew. I wonder if it's intuitive, though.
Like against like, your feelings?
Yeah, it's like,
yes.
Why would I do that? That doesn't make sense. So that would be intuitive, correct? Yes. So no bonk. You're actually correcting your dog for being excited to go on a walk. But I want the dog to like the walk. I want my dogs to like the walk, too. And my dogs love the walk. But your dog is making it difficult to get it ready for the walk. That's what you're correcting.
Yeah.
Next.
€4.99 from Ooh, Victoria.
Look at that. Thank you so much.
Robbie, I already read that. Kathy, oh, geez. I don't know what I just did. Sorry, guys. Clicking on random stuff here. Kathy, my mom and I, struggled with it for a while, but now we are not afraid to turn the remote on 100 because those behaviors are not acceptable. UK, she's so vocal. She screams, but we are over it.
Yeah, so this is the thing is that, like, you know, nobody should enjoy correcting their dog on high levels.
No.
Nobody should. They just shouldn't. Frankly, you shouldn't enjoy your overweight dog either. You know? So, I mean, there's a lot of things you shouldn't enjoy about your dog. I don't like to see my dog, like one of my dogs is going to the vet tomorrow because she's got an ear infection. I don't like to see her in discomfort. You know, she winces a lot now. I don't like to see that. But, you know, but when I'm trying to stop a dangerous behavior, I'm sorry, I'm going to make it suck. Because the alternative could be the death of the dog, the injury of the dog, the injury of a person, financial like expense to me, a lost dog, so many different variables, But, and also remember, we train with rewards. I train with positive reinforcement. But when I want to stop something, I'm not going to fuck around.
Right.
Especially a behavior. Oh, the dog doesn't hold a good down and it learned it yesterday. I'm not going to correct you for that. But behavior, attitude, oh, you're going to get corrected. It's your that's your job. It's your job as a dog owner to do that. That's one of the responsibilities of owning an animal, is to keep it safe and to keep other animals safe, other people safe, and the community safe. That is your obligation to dog ownership. Next.
Kara, good evening, guys. When trying to walk into a dog during the e-collar spatial exercise, what do you do if the dog sits or lays down instead of moving away?
Keep moving. Walk right into them. They'll do that on purpose. Sometimes they come up and try to bite you, too. So be careful. Move into them.
Sometimes we have ones that literally will plant themselves, though. So we just have someone else with a long line.
Pull them
away. So as we walk into them, they're popping them away.
But or you can just, like, literally just, like, walk into them and shuffle your feet. They'll move. Or use your knees. They'll move. Next.
Angela, hey, I'm training my five-year-old bearded collie who is very nervous and reactive to strangers. She's made a massive improvement with the e-collar and prong outside, but inside the house, she will lunge and try to bite the stranger.
Not good. So set it up. So again, we talk about, did I do a thing? I think I did a thing setting up the fail already, right? Yeah, I think I did.
Yes, so, twice, actually.
So you want to set your dog up to fail. Of course we want to set our dogs up for success. Of course. And we do. But Mother Nature doesn't give a shit about stuff like that. Mother Nature is going to set you up personally to fail, and also COVID. And then also Mother Nature is going to set your dog up to fail. So why don't we set our dogs up to fail in a highly choreographed routine that we can control the consequence, we can control the potential outcome, and we can control the rebound from it. I'd rather do that. So what do? Dog on a tie back, have strangers walk by in your house. The dog doesn't look like it's going to aggress. Click reward. But look, intent, intent. Not the dog didn't lunge. But guess what? It stared with its like looking like it was going to bite. No. We correct that. The dog was just like, "Hey, buddy, nice shoes." Click reward. Thank you very much. Next.
Vegan power couple. My dog killed a bird today while we were outside. An injured bird was next to him and I hadn't seen it. And all of a sudden my dog has it in its mouth. I corrected and he came right back, but I feel awful about this. Thoughts?
You feel awful because he's not vegan anymore? Because he's a meat eater?
Because he killed a bird.
So.
Well, the bird was injured. He probably just put it out of his misery.
So this is the thing, is that like I killed one of my chickens the other day. Why? Because if I didn't, we'll put it this way. The reason why I killed the chicken is because the other chickens were doing a half-assed job of killing it.
Isn't that so, like, chickens are like.
Chickens are nasty motherfuckers. Disgusting.
They like eat mice and stuff. They are nasty.
They'll kill rats.
And meanwhile, people eat chicken.
Yes, I know. So obviously the chicken was sick. It was on the ground, and the other chickens were pecking at it.
Ugh.
It already had flies around it, but it wasn't dead. So Linda calls me up. She's like, Jeff, can you come home and kill the chicken? I'm like, give me a fucking break. We have kids. That's why you have kids.
Are you serious? I would not. Now.
You're not my kid.
But like, what? No.
I said, tell Clover to get a fucking shovel and chop off its head.
No.
She wouldn't.
You can't have your kid. I would never.
She's killed rats before.
Okay. But a chicken? That's like a pet.
I told her to take the chicken and throw it in Max's kennel.
Oh my God. You are deranged.
She wouldn't do that either. So I went home. I killed the fucking chicken.
Mac wouldn't eat it with feathers. And it was sick.
He'd kill it. Mac?
Most dogs are weird with feathers.
Mac will kill anything. He'll kill anything moving. Doesn't care. That's why he's our outside dog. So I went over and killed it. So this is the thing. I don't feel bad. I put out of its misery. So don't feel bad. I can't tell you not to feel bad, but don't feel bad. Next.
Elias. I have a 1.5-year-old Cane Corso. We go on walks every day. He's on a prong collar. And all of a sudden, he's afraid of me or doesn't come near me on the walks. I never correct him harshly. He only acts this way during walks. Not sure why this is happening.
I don't know. Some people will tell you it's the prong collar, but it's not. Dog could be going through a fear stage, which it's not. It's definitely changing. Year and a half old, 18 months old. It's getting into full maturity.
How does that work, though? He doesn't come near you on a walk. Isn't he on a leash? Like, so where's the dog?
Yeah, so pull him closer to you. Pull him closer to you. Reward. Do food training. If he's really nervous, he won't take the food. If he takes food, he's not that nervous. He's just out of body position. Mm. Work on spatial pressure exercises. Work on your healing exercises. Turn right into the dog. Turn left in the dog. Just literally, like, you know, pull him into you. You can actually correct the dog to get closer to you.
Next. Steve, hey guys, I love your content. Use it daily.
Oh, thanks. So do we.
Melissa posted the link to my Patreon channel. Thank you, Melissa.
Thank you so much. And you have a link still to Miss Health?
The link is in your my stories.
So if you go to Joelle, guys, please go to Joelle's
Instagram
channel, which you can get it to her Patreon channel. Melissa, can you see if you can find the hyperlink to the competition that Joelle is in for Miss Health to make the cover of Miss Health magazine, please? And could you post that up so everyone can vote on that, please? Thank you. Next.
Jesse, how do I get my dog to stop chasing cats? I use the e-collar. I can be shocking him, and he keeps chasing as he's yelping while chasing the cat.
So what you there we go. So think about that.
Dog don't care.
Dog don't care. Drive overrides a lot of discomfort.
Yep.
Drive overrides discomfort. Now that's a meme.
Ooh.
Ooh. That's meme. I came up with another meme. I wrote it down today.
Wes once ran through a cattle fence to chase a ball.
Overrides discomfort.
Screamed in and then screamed out, right, bringing the ball back.
So he didn't give a shit.
No.
So this is what I want you to do. You either got to catch, you got to set the dog up, and you got to catch him earlier. You got to catch the dog when he starts looking at the cat and put the dog into avoidance. You got to double collar the dog, which is a more powerful collar. Most collars are not very, I don't want to say they're not very powerful, but I mean, I've maxed out. I've just for shits and giggles, I've maxed out a collar on 100 on my neck. It was not comfortable, but I did it. And here's a great example what I tell people. If you put $10 in the corner and you maxed and you shocked me at 100, I ain't moving. You put $1,000 in the corner, guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to scream, but I'm going to fucking keep running till I get that $1,000.
Yeah, I'd probably do it.
Yeah, of course, Tamara, you would. You'd do it for $500.
I don't know.
You wouldn't? $500.
See, the thing is like, if I'm controlling the remote, it's different. But if I have somebody else controlling the remote and you don't, like, you have that anticipation of, like, when it's going to happen or not.
Okay, how about this? It's an automatic remote. You push the button. It stays on till you come back, until you push it again. They don't have those remotes, by the way, but let's say we
invented it. Oh, my God. So you're getting it the whole time?
Yeah. But you're controlling it, though.
I'd have to have it, like, right there. Like, boom.
Okay.
Okay.
You'd do it for 500.
Yeah.
So you would do it for 500.
Probably.
So also, you can use a bonker too.
I've done it accidentally.
So a bonker actually can be more powerful than a remote. Next.
Dana says, hello. Wish you guys were closer.
Well, how much closer do you want to be? I mean, I can get. Is that close enough? What the fuck?
Melissa, that's a clip.
How much closer do you want me to get?
Great.
Damn.
Lou said yes, I'm in New Zealand.
Hope I didn't see any boogers.
Probably.
You think so?
Oh my God.
Is my nose up or down?
Jade, thanks, guys. I really appreciate your advice. You're right, wrong person in the door. I know what I must do. Thank you.
Good for you, Jade.
Melissa, Joelle, did you snatch Jeff's backup pair of glasses? Oh, well, y'all are twinning hard right now. Jeff just needs a man bun. We do. We both have gray in our glasses.
I can do a man bun.
Yeah, and you're just going to, like, get a blonde bun going on. Go. Jeff, you just tie your hair in a knot. Like, what the hell? He's gonna have a rat's nest on his head.
When I was a teenager, they used to call me tying in a knot Gellman.
Tie it in a knot Gellman.
Yeah.
Did you ever rock a man bun?
No, it's a penis it's a penis joke.
Oh. Why? Why is that a?
Because when you tie your dick in a knot, you can't use it.
Oh.
Next.
I didn't know that was possible. So anyway, Jade, thanks, guys. I really appreciate your advice. You're right. I already read that.
Yep.
Morgan, 8-month puppy was exposed to a laser
point. Oh, my God. No. You don't even have to.
Let me guess. She's neurotic. And now she's neurotic.
You don't have to continue.
Ay, ay, ay.
So what is it? What's the question?
How do I help her?
Oh, is it? Is that what it was? She's neurotic? Yeah. 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 So what you do is this. Again, sounds counterintuitive and productive. Teach your dog a really good downstay. Really good downstay. Make sure it knows the command down. It knows it really well. Leash on the dog, remote collar or prong on the dog, laser pointer, 1 second split laser, boom, dog moves, no, correct.
I think that's how I stopped.
What you're going to do is you're going to desensitize your dog, just like any other environmental you would do.
Yep.
You're going to desensitize your dog to the laser pointer. Next.
Wes would chase dust particles.
Yeah.
Like the light coming through. I had to like correct him for that. I'm like, you're literally driving yourself nuts.
I remember going to a client's house. This is back. I started my career on the road. Mm-hmm. Okay. 8 years going to people's houses, which is why I think I'm really good at stopping stuff really quick because you have no choice. You're there for an hour.
No.
And and their life needs to like go on.
Right.
This dog, when they turned the ceiling fan on,
lost the shit.
The ceiling fan's going around, creates a shadow on the ground.
Oh God.
Okay. It sees the shadow on the ground. It gets all ramped up and it attacks them.
Oh my God. Damn.
No ceiling fan, no attack. Literally a month straight, no attack. Ceiling fan on, boom.
Interesting.
Yep.
Bryce, brother, I'm just kidding. Bryce Bowes. Yep. Just wanted to say thanks so much for what you guys do. I've learned so much from you guys and gained so much confidence.
Nice. Nice.
Clyde, my dog won't walk with a prong collar. He just lies down, and when I try to pull him, he just lies.
Okay, what does he lie about? His age? His weight?
Liar.
Okay, liar, liar, pants on fire. Tease him. Okay, he'll move. So this is what I want you to do. This is not a prong collar conversation. I've seen dogs do that on flat buckle collars. I say this because I want to make sure that folks understand that it's not about the prong collar. It's about the attitude of the dog. Mm-hmm. It's really important to understand that. I've seen dogs do that on flat buckle collars, martingale collars, gentle leaders, harnesses, even the easy walk harness. Ain't fucking nothing easy about this because you ain't moving and you're 80 pounds. Okay?
Yep.
Easiest way for me to end up in the emergency room. So your dog is just saying no. You know why I know how? This, do I know how?
You know why I know how?
Me how?
You know why I know how about that?
Me how? Somebody cup. My Thai and my Chinese, like all in one. I'm not gonna say, oh, it's my Korean. Okay, anyway. So, what I want you to do is this. You know how you know? You know how I know how?
Oh my God, stop.
Unclip the leash. I bet you the dog runs around.
Of course.
And so, it's not a prong collar conversation. The dog just like saying, fuck you. So, what do? A couple of different things. Pop, pop, pop. Like pretty forceful. Or literally put the leash around your waist and start walking. Next.
Eliana, how do I not overwhelm my dog? I grow space with my body and keep her in heel, but she does try and forge ahead.
Watch our spatial pressure video. You have to be a Patreon member. It's on our Patreon channel in the Do It Yourself 2020 playlist. Next.
Amanda said Joan Rivers.
Yep. Very good. I'll send you a link to that.
Monica Brown said Church Lady.
Yes, exactly.
Never heard of it. Abandoned Entity. Do I crouch higher than working level for known commands? I don't know if I'm underwhelming him because I'll ask for a sit and he tries to go into a down instead, despite having done hundreds of reps.
Okay. Working level is literally what it says, is working level. But if you've done hundreds of commands, you should only be on correction level. In other words, there should be no food involved because you've done enough. You've done enough working level, or NCS, as we call it, non-compliant stim. All right. So you go to, whenever you go to correction level, it's at a correction. Correction level is higher than working level because working level is just like you're working. Correction level is you didn't listen. Next.
I would just make sure too they've got a leash on with that.
Always have a
lot
leash
of dogs,
on.
Once they get into that down, boom, they're not going back into a sit. Yes. You have to like kind of teach them.
Yep. Also, what you can do is, what does he go through? She says sit.
Any downs.
You would do a whole day of just sitting, no downs. Also, teach sitting in chairs. It's not going to eliminate the problem, but it's going to really solidify the sit better too.
Elise had to deal with strong fear, shaking, peeing around loud tractors outside. Too scared to go out for fear I typically put in place and correct for breaking. Yes. I've never seen such terrified dogs. She starts flailing. Yeah,
no, we've seen that before. We've seen dogs that have got this makes sense. It's a tractor, but we've seen dogs that are afraid of like the most irrational things. It's like,
yeah.
Like, are you serious? That's a coffee pot. I know it's decaf. That sort of freaks me out too, but it's a coffee pod. Get over it. All right. So what do? You can correct that. You are correcting it though, aren't you? No, you're not. You're using obedience. Correct it. Correct it. What I want you to do is be outside, be far away from the tractor, do some counter. It's sort of like a shortened BAT protocol. BAT takes too long. Just a shortened version of that. So get a little bit closer.
Said it's too scared to go out though.
Oh, just pull it out. Drag it outside. Oh my God, that'll make it worse. No, it won't.
Yeah, the dog's going to be like, oh, the sky didn't fall.
No,
oh,
okay. It won't make it worse. How do I know that? Because I've done this thousands of times. That's why. Okay. Fire escapes on the outside of buildings, at least in New England, I imagine everywhere, they're made out of metal. There's no back to them, mm-hmm. and you can see right through them. Then when you get to the top or you get to a level, there's a landing. Historically, those landings are metal, and you can see right down through them. A lot of dogs are afraid of those. A lot of dogs put the brakes on. Mm-hmm. Guess what I do? The first time I go up them, what do? I go up them. Dog, you better keep up because I'm going up them. Mm-hmm. Okay? And I'm not just walking full speed. I give a little bit of encouragement, you know, but I'm going up them. First time looks horrific. Guess what happens the second time? Half as horrific. Third time, dog does it perfectly. Fourth time, put a word to it. Guess what? Whoop, dog does it. All in less than historically 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. Next.
Kira says it was on Saturday Night Live.
Yes.
Irene said, I think Joan Rivers used to say, can we talk?
Yes.
Abandoned entity. I know he's very versed in his commands, but he just seems to have days where he wants to offer something different from what I asked. I just switched to a dog trust and getting the hang of it.
Yeah. So a lot of dogs will do that. Or it could be handler error. And he actually doesn't know. So spend a good day making sure the dog knows each command and then say, okay, dog, you're playing me. All right, next.
Hannah, congratulations on your Yiddish. Oy vey, my bladder nearly leaked a little. When did you speak Yiddish?
I spoke Yiddish the other day on the show. I spoke Yiddish on, what's the day that we said?
Do you know Yiddish?
What?
Are you like fluent? Do you know other languages that I don't know about?
I know a lot of languages.
Do you really?
Yes.
Like fluently, though?
I'm not going to disclose my linguistic capabilities to you. You don't need to know that stuff.
Why?
Because. Let's go.
I don't think you know it. Okay. Why would I not know that now?
Do you think you know everything about me?
I've known you for like a pretty good amount of time. Uh-huh. I didn't know you're fluent in other languages. Are you? Like, why is it a secret? I'd be like bragging. Like, damn right, I know 5 languages.
Let's go. Next.
Andrea, Saturday Night Live, Michael Myers. Next. Crystal, I love my prong collar.
Yes.
Lies, too. Lenny, hey guys.
Hey, Lies.
Cam, I see all these fantastic.
Lies, nice knife you got in the house now, huh? Damn.
What?
They got Olivia's knife.
Oh.
Yeah.
Cam, I see all these fantastic Malinois that are trained to heel flush up the owner's side with no leash, and I'm super jealous.
Don't be.
My dog is a Chihuahua mix and heels okay with a prong.
But okay, hold on. Stop right there. Stop right there. Cam.
Teach your Chihuahua a nice foos, would you? Okay.
You're comparing your Chihuahua to a fucking Malinois?
Hold on. She's not done yet.
Okay.
My dog is a Chihuahua mix and heels okay with a prong, but sometimes she falls a bit behind or walks quite a bit of space between us. She checks in with me periodically, but isn't zeroed in like these Mals I see. How can I get her to that type of level of engagement?
Okay, you can. It's all done with food. It's all done with toy drive. But it's also a Malinois. Why do you primarily see Malinois and German Shepherds doing that? But historically, Malinois, and they're prancing. That doesn't mean you can't do it with other breeds, but they're Malinois. I own a Malinois.
Imagine you do Chihuahua focus.
You can. You can run it. You can run a. I've seen small breeds go through Schutzen courses before.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next. But to make your heel better, watch some of our free content on our YouTube channel. Next.
Lies, Lenny. Joelle, I'll be on your Patreon soon. Awesome.
Thank you.
Gretchen. Hi, guys. Raining hard outside. Gonna walk cows. I bike there, too. Good 20-minute ride one way. Hope y'all had a good day.
You gotta walk a cow?
Walk cows? I know. I was thinking that, too. I thought they just walked themselves. Maybe not.
You know, when we were in the Swiss Alps.
Oh, geez. This one time when I went backpacking through Europe. It's true. You have. You know, Friends. Who's watched Friends? Joey Tribbiani. I once went backpacking. He used it to pick up chicks. That was his line. This one time when I was backpacking through Europe.
I used it to talk about the great bonding experience I had with my daughters.
Cool.
But anyway.
I'm sure you used it to pick up chicks at one point.
No, never have. Nope, I've never have.
Okay, continue.
I just started speaking a foreign language. That usually worked.
Yeah.
No, go on. Next question.
Great. Ashley, listening while driving. Great tips and info on the last Zoom. Thanks, and Joelle, you were killing it, girl. Yay for both of you.
Yeah, Joelle's doing really, really great.
Thanks, Ashley. Jessica, love your show. How do I keep my one-year-old Siberian Husky from counter surfing? The food on the counter is worth bonking for her. LOL.
Meaning
it's worth the bonking.
Right, exactly. Exactly. Remote collar on 100 for 3 seconds. One, on the highest level, make sure you got a good fit. One, two, three. Does it hurt? Yes, it does. I thought you weren't supposed to train with pain. Uh-huh. Do you know a dog that counter surfs, there's a good chance they'll end up in the emergency room and be split open and have it removed. And then guess what else has to open up? Your wallet. And then you'll be crying. And I'm being 100%
serious. Or dead. If they eat something with xylitol in it, they're dead.
Yep.
Like there's no.
Yep. Speaking of Malinois, counter surfing, and dead dogs, have I got a story for you? Someone that Joelle knows had a less than one-year-old Malinois who got on the counter, ate a bottle of aspirin, and died. Now, anybody out there that has a heart, and I have a big heart, people that actually know me know this, I have no problem using a remote collar on the highest level to prevent something like that from ever happening again. And all dog owners should be, in my opinion, should be prepared. If you own a dog, you should be prepared to correct it.
One point or another,
Wait, for something. That doesn't mean you spend your life doing it, but there's going to be something that it does that it's going to warrant it. Next.
Remember when Wes used to climb on the freaking front
desk? Yeah, there you go. Yep.
He used to climb on the front desk of work. And sit up there like a cat.
But explain it more than that. It's more of like, it's
like a bar, like an island. Like,
yes. Like a guest check-in where there's a desk, but then there's a countertop.
A thin little countertop. Yes. He would climb on it.
And he'd be on the thin countertop. Like, yeah. And meanwhile, he's at face level now with people coming in.
Yes.
Yes. And that's back when he was dog aggressive.
Highly corrected for that.
Yes. Yep. I remember you couldn't do it.
I know. I made you do it.
It's so funny. Joelle is such a badass with dogs.
Wait, for his dog aggression, though,
okay,
I have laid down the law. But for stuff like that, I'm like, who's not really doing any harm? Like,
so one time that
you do it.
The one time that I had to correct him for being help you for dog aggression?
I ran remote, though, still.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm proud of you.
But he blows through.
Oh, that's right. I had to get physical with him. Yeah. Next.
So we've all had to do it at one point or another. Anyway, Melissa posted a link to your Patreon channel. Oh,
thank you.
Pulsar Dog Training. Do you guys correct whining unspoken? Do you say no or use tone?
So we historically just correct. I hate whining. But you could use tone as a no marker and then go to correct. Next. Or you could just say no and then correct. Depends on where you are in the room.
Victoria, I'm so sorry if I missed it. Did you answer my question? So sorry if you did. I'm so tired, but I love to watch these chats.
Yes, Victoria. You're going to have to watch the replay or scroll back. Next.
Daniel, is a reactive German Shepherd.
What did you do? Fall asleep in the middle of the fucking show?
Maybe.
Am I that boring?
Yeah.
Jeez, I guess we got to liven up a little bit more.
I think she's in the UK, though. I think she was that top chat that came through, but there was no question attached to it.
There was no question. But because I remember seeing your icon.
Yeah.
There was no question. No, ask your question again.
She's like 6 hours ahead.
Right.
So it's late there.
Yeah, got it.
Daniel.
No, your top chat came in. Yep.
Is a reactive German Shepherd and a 6-foot leash a good way to social distance?
only if the dog has a mask on. Next.
Juan, I try to train my Great Dane for a nose leader, but he keeps doing the crocodile roll and won't stop. It's been 2 months.
Oh,
and
no Jesus Christ. 2 months? Ooh. 2 months?
It's rough.
So 2 months of anything. Well, not anything. I mean, rehabbing aggression does take some time. But to get it stopping crocodile roll, I'd put a prong collar on that dog. And if he does a crocodile roll, say no, bonk him. You can correct it. See, this is the thing. You can correct. There's a couple of general rules when it comes to correcting. If a dog makes the choice to do it or not. That's usually what it is. You chose to crocodile roll. The dog made a conscious choice. Why is my dog crocodile rolling? The only time I ever see him crocodile roll is when you put a gentle leader on him. Okay, but if I want to train with a gentle leader and you want a crocodile roll, so you can bonk him for that. So if we get the prong collar, keep using the nose harness, say no, bonk. Next.
Angela said, thank you so much. Brandy said, you did not.
I did not what?
Kill the chicken.
Of course I did.
I think that's what it's about.
I had to.
Because Brian then said a chicken is not a pet.
So this, well, they are. I mean, I think they're
pets.
They're sources of a food source for us. They lay eggs. But this is the thing. By the time I got home, the chicken was out of the pen because they got it out of the pen. It's like, use the shovel. She used the shovel to get the chicken out of the pen. But you couldn't take the damn shovel and use it as a spade and chop off its head?
No. Oh, my God.
What kind of daughter is that? Clover, come on. So anyway, so I got there. Its head's all messed up. The chickens had already destroyed half of its body. And then it flies all over it, but it was still alive. What am I going to do, take it to the vet? Ew.
No, but it's like you don't get to, like, share that. So grotesque.
I didn't share it. I threw it in the garbage.
Chopped its head off.
I didn't share it.
I probably would have, like,
what?
Shot the thing.
Oh, you can't discharge a firearm in Providence. Okay. What the hell? What?
Siri's like, sorry, I wasn't able to share that for you.
See?
Siri, he tried to kill the chicken.
Next.
He did kill the chicken.
Even Siri's pissed at me.
Tracy, my German Shepherd has anxiety. How long should I walk and play with her to help her burn that anxiety
off?
No,
you can't burn anxiety off. You're not going to burn anxiety off. Anxiety is, there's a lot of different ways to stop anxiety. Yes, I'm a huge advocate of exercise. I'm a huge advocate of play. Huge advocate of proper diet. Huge advocate of training your dog's obedience commands. Huge advocate of sports, of activities. But it's not going to solve the anxiety. Anxiety has to be, theoretically, you correct anxiety. Next. But there's a protocol on how to do that. So, next.
Victoria, so Joelle, post the link to your channel. I think Melissa did
already.
Melissa
did. So you can go to patreon.com/Joelle Gifford. It's there's no little thing in between Joelle and Gifford.
No.
Joelle Gifford. That's two Fs.
Peggy, my grown daughter left home now, and her 4-year-old Aussie can't live there but can visit. She loves to go places with her but not stay over. And last time she stayed over, she was sad and pouted and wouldn't play. And when she came home, she hid for a day, like saying, please don't send me away again. Very frustrating. But not surprising. She's rather overly sensitive to the point of being neurotic. Any suggestions?
Yeah, Peggy. I think you're humanizing this a little bit. A little bit. Dogs sometimes don't like changes in their routine. But for your dog to be implying, please don't send me away anymore, and the dog was pouty, I'm not making fun of you, Peggy. So don't write me hate mail. Like a lot of first-time listeners do when I mock, make fun, or like get sarcastic with them. So this is the thing. Is it possible that you, Peggy, when the dog comes home, have got it in your mind that the dog didn't enjoy itself and that you might be using words, phrases, facial expressions, body language that might imply, oh, you didn't like it there. And the dog is like, I'm going to fucking milk this for all it's worth. Is that at all possible? Next.
Kathy B. Hi, everyone. Was clipping nails. Almost forgot the live. All three dogs. Oh, jeez. Shoot, I got to do Burton's nails. And Wes's one dew claw.
Really?
It's the only one that doesn't get filed down from him running.
Next.
It's like so long.
I know, it's true.
Andrea, love your content. Has helped me so much. Thanks and keep it up.
Thanks.
Carrie, I have an 11-month-old foster pit bull who is smarter than I am. He loses focus.
So Carrie, training. Your dog's typing this, right?
So we are stuck on come, sit, break. He is terrified of the e-collar and is my first time using one. How can I keep his focus?
Okay, so why? So he's not smarter than you. You just haven't figured out yet how to motivate the dog. A remote collar, we have videos on remote collars on how to use them. Place, I would suggest being the first one, the first command to train. We have something called CS and NCS. We have a whole program on how to do it. Okay. Also, you can go to our YouTube channel. You can find stuff. There's a lot of free videos on there. Also, it comes with an owner's manual. As far as getting focused on you, become important to your dog. Become valuable to your dog. Stop letting your dog go up to people. Stop letting your dog go up to other dogs. I'm not against play and I'm not against meeting. But become everything for your dog. Be more demanding. That doesn't mean mean. It means to be more demanding. Next.
Brian, my GSD is doing great on leash and in the house. She loves her prong and it's work time. However, outside, she thinks she can do what she wants off leash. Should I use a long training lead and positive reinforcement, which she is responsive to, or should I move her up to an e-collar? My concern is always having to use an e-collar, though I know it's a good security blanket off leash.
So, Brian, it's so funny. People that have never used an e-collar will always say, am I always going to have to use an e-collar?
Yeah.
So it's like, but you haven't even started yet. You haven't even started. So it's sort of like saying, oh, I don't want to lose 200 pounds because then I'm going to always have to eat healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean?
Yep.
It's like, oh my God, I'm going to always have to go to the gym and always have to eat healthy. So instead, I'm just going to stay overweight. And I'm not fat shaming anybody, so don't fucking give me any shit, people, okay? So I'm always going to be overweight and die early. You know what I mean? It's like, so, and I'm not mocking you, Brian. So this is the thing. All dogs respond well to positive reinforcement, to train obedience commands. Now, here's the kicker. You're outside. Massive amounts of distractions. Now your dog doesn't care about a lot of the training that you did inside. So you've got to use sometimes more of a motivation. It could be more leash compulsion. Remote collars also is not just for correcting. Remote collars we can use in a positive reinforcement mode. Do you know that I can also use a clicker as a marker for the word no? I can make a clicker a precursor to a punisher. They don't know what it is until you tell the dog what it is. Okay? So the thing about a remote collar is it's a great insurance policy. Next.
Melissa posted the link to vote for me for Miss Health and Fitness. Thank you.
Nice.
Kara, use his face close to the camera in the intro, please. Melissa, please make that the intro. Victoria, €4.99. My question was about my Rottie barking at a weird man sat in the park. Is this normal? She hasn't barked or attacked at the Amazon man. Haha.
What parks are you going to where there's mere weird men sitting naked in a on a bench?
She didn't say naked. Weird man sat in the park.
Oh, I saw the word naked. Okay. I was like, what is this, a swingers club you're at?
Oh, my God.
So what was the question? What should she do?
Yeah.
Correct me. No, correct. No, correct. I think you meant, did you skip a bunch? Oh, no.
No.
Yes, you did. About
no,
the,
I didn't.
People can click on you to vote on you.
I said that Melissa posted the link.
Oh, by the way, guys, click back up.
I am.
There's a link there. Vote for Joelle here, MissHealthAndFitness.com.
Yeah, I can pin it. How do I show it?
Go to this.
Show.
Show it.
There we go.
Leave it there the whole fucking show.
Guys, I need votes. I need daily votes.
There you go.
Leanne, Joelle will have to teach Jeff how to do the messy bun.
Whoa.
I can teach you.
Whoa, hold on here. Take your hair down, Joelle.
No, it's a mess.
Take your hair down.
Why?
I want to show people something.
Show people what? Do you know how to do a bun?
Turn around.
Turn also, around mess. This way?
Yeah.
Ow!
You guys watching this? You guys watching?
It's really rough.
That's what she said.
What are you doing? This doesn't feel right. This is not right. This is not a bun. Like, what are you doing? Ow! Is there a pen in my hand?
Stop right there. Okay? Don't mess with me about hairstyles, okay?
It looks great.
Okay? Do you know that I used to... I had a push cart. One of my first businesses was a push cart. And we had, what the fuck were these things called? These sticks. What were they called? Damn it. I got to remember. There's these sticks. You buy them in pairs and they're made. Technically, they're like really expensive pencils.
Oh my God, my that you, that
you do, that you do your hair in. So I used to do hairstyles all day long. I can do the one you roll a lot. I did
and
shit
you put
for
pencils in them.
No, well, they're not pencils. They're really beautiful sticks. They sold for like $100 a pair. They came in little fabric bags.
Beautiful
I used to do shit for like wedding hairstyles, all kinds of stuff. So watch yourself there.
All righty. Jeff can do pen buns in your hair. All right. This show just gets weirder every single time I come on it. Anyway, abandoned entity. Oh, yeah. We spent a whole day or two running through sit down and stand. He's part collie, so I think he's trying to mess with me. Definitely going to spend some time doing chair reps. Thanks, guys.
So it's not the collie part. It's he's a dog and he's trying to mess with you. Next.
Victoria, no, getting ready for bed, asking if it was okay behavior about my Roddy.
I mean, it's not unusual. Your dog might have, you know, did your dog sense something? It might have startled your dog. It's not unusual. Still, you can't have your Rottweiler barking at people in the park, you know, just randomly like that. So you can say no and correct. Next.
Brian, our chickens lay eggs and are for meat.
Yes, they are.
Barista boy, love this show.
Thank you, barista boy.
Loretta, when my dog doesn't want to do something, he lays down and won't go anywhere.
Yep, it's called an objection. And kids,
I am a rock.
Kids do the same thing.
Yeah.
With their arms crossed, all pouty.
Yep.
Yep, they do the same thing. And I'm like, kid, until you pay rent, you can't make a decision. Get the fuck going. Let's go. Next.
Loretta, when my dog doesn't, I just read that. Scott, what can be done about submissive peeing?
So Scott, submissive peeing is actually can be a challenging one. Excitement, submissive pee, just like this. So what we do is this. We don't directly, we stop all pee stuff, but we don't directly attack it. We stop car sickness, but we don't directly attack it. What we do is we put the dog through a very structured training program. Permission-based, highly structured, accountability, a lot of leadership skills, all the stuff I teach in all my videos, and you'll find submissive peeing just stops. Watch your tone of voice, stay voice neutral, more permission-based stuff, be consistent, turn it into a lifestyle, and you'll find that it stops. Next.
Kara, is it unheard of to correct whining with a high level? My dog won't shut up when we pull up in the car to a new place,
if
he's in a double down the entire ride. I've tried high and low, but haven't tried 70 or higher.
So there are dogs out there that
they
get so excited to go run in the woods, go swimming in the ocean, swimming in a lake, go to their favorite friend's house to play, you know, that they won't shut the fuck up. Okay. So if anything, it can make them ramp up even more. So you felt it's like, holy shit, who even knew you do that active? So it's like, whoa.
You just like spit on me. Thanks.
Sorry.
The show is out of
control. So
done. You have two more minutes.
So
you're done.
So I'd go higher. I'd go lower. I'd go momentary. I'd go continuous. I would bonk. I would try anything next.
Juan, how do you train a dog to come to you when he's loose?
You want to. So it's called recall training. So recall training is literally name of dog here or name of dog come, and it's a protocol. We have a free video online. It's obviously done on a leash. And it's done through a formal training protocols. Like it's just a standard operating procedure on how to train. There's a lot of different ways to train recall, but it is definitely a step-by-step type of thing. So what you can do, Juan, is you can look on our YouTube channel, how to train recall, but also just go into the main Google and how to train recall. You're going to see a lot of videos on that. All right, next.
Peggy, LOL, nope, I ignored her. My husband babied her. Haha, love your stuff.
Okay, thanks. So I would have a talk with your husband next.
Carrie, thank you so much.
You're welcome, Carrie.
Brian, thank you for that answer. And I feel fat shame now. Seriously, much appreciated, guys.
You're wonderful.
I got bumped. Victoria said he wasn't naked. He was weird. We live in a really nice area.
So what made him weird? People think I'm weird.
You are weird.
Yeah.
It's not think. It's no. You're weird. Kathy said they're called chignon sticks.
So there was a name brand, though, to them.
Chignon.
There was a name brand to them. But you're on the right track, Kathy.
Tiffany said chopsticks.
You're on the...
With an X.
You're on the right track. They were very expensive chopsticks, though. And they at the end of them, they had all kinds of baubles, beads, stones, beautiful stuff. It was a specific name brand.
How does it keep your hair up, though? I feel like it would just fall right out.
Pencils do.
How?
What do you mean, how?
I feel like this you've only works because French... you have the little clip there.
No. You've never done a French twist?
No.
You've never done a rolled braid?
Nope. I've always had my hair down. I would hate when my mom touched my hair.
Okay.
Like, don't touch it. This is a rat's nest on my head growing up.
Do a French twist.
Yeah.
Next show.
God, I enjoy you guys. You make me laugh several times every show.
Thanks, Lou.
It's 8:01. Oh, look, everyone's voting. Thank you guys so much. See I that? Appreciate it.
Nice.
All right. Oh, my God. It's a lot of questions.
I know. We got this 7-something. One more question.
Okay.
No, we got pretty far.
Yeah. David, when training two dogs, how do you get them to follow commands separately?
So we don't usually train. Well, I shouldn't say that. No, we do, because in the training center, we'll have 3, 4, 5 dogs
out. So what we do, technically.
Or Joel will answer the question.
The way we train recall is the dog's name and then the word here, but we say it almost like it's one word. So technically, the dog's name becomes part of the cue. So if you have two dogs, it's like you shouldn't be recalling when I recalled that dog. Like, their name is in the cue.
How about for sitting down?
You would just put the dog's name right before.
Hmm. How about if the other dog moved?
You correct it.
Good.
Depending on the level of obedience that they're at.
Cool. There you go. All right, guys.
There you go. It's 8:02 p.m.
There you go.
You've seen my hair get done. You've seen Jeff spit on me tonight. You've heard Jeff speak.
Sounds like a bad porn movie.
Fluid multi-languages by Jeff get spoken. Definitely, talked about killing chickens.
It definitely sounds like a bad porn movie now.
This is like a really interesting show.
That's right. And you're in like secretary glasses.
I know.
Librarian glasses.
Like, I don't think I've ever had my hair up on the show ever.
Well, if you wear a hat sometimes.
Yeah, but not like up like this. Yeah.
All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. And this is Joel. Wednesday. Willie will see you Friday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Can't wait.
Friday night, not Wednesday.
Did I say Friday? I said tonight's Wednesday. I'll see you Friday night.
Oh.
Maybe not.
Maybe I wasn't paying attention.
That wouldn't be unusual. Mm-hmm. All right. Because especially when I'm talking. All right. Talk to you guys soon. Love you all.
Good night. Bye-bye.